Well, you know my philosophy. Are there any flags? You know what? It wasn't passing.
It wasn't?
That took care of that. It looked like he made
Coach, you got on my back before the ball got there?
Yes, I understand. But do you also understand there's no yellow flag on the ground?
All right, incomplete pass right there. We'll stop with 11:08 in the first quarter. A big first quick third down coming up for the Jags. Last night, we had the Chiefs coming through on the third down and fourth down possessions. They went like 5 for 5 on the first 5 attempts at third and fourth down. Here we go, Pablo.
All right, Econ got twins left, twins right. Shotgun. Oh, they have. It's a free play, and he didn't take advantage of it. That what happened was one of the defensive linemen, not only did he jump off sides, he slammed into the offensive lineman, and it was such force that it pretty much sent anybody in the shot. Quarterback. They snapped the ball. It's a free play. Launch it.
Pablo, we talked about what Max Salinas has going when you get that free play. Do you think every team has it, or do you, I mean, as a coach?
You know, well, you would think that they would, but since we've been here, certainly that I see in the Valley, there's only one team that is automatic. As receivers look in and they see a man jump outside, you know you caught him. That's an instant fade route for the Sabercats, and they've capitalized a few times on that. Why not? It's a free play, don't
they? Yeah, they sure did. It'll bring up a third and four coming up, a free 5 yards. That should be the first penalty of the night. It went against the Bears' first flag for 5 yards.
David Garcia. It's going to be a reverse to the right. Whoa! Gives, I'll tell you what, great defensive stance. I'll tell you what, I got to give credit, Donut, to Lee Mata. As he comes up from his outside linebacker position on the reverse, and he turned the run inside. Great, good technique.
Fourth and two, Pena?
I don't believe it.
They got a punt?
Yes, sir, it looks like. And I'll tell you what, we know we're kind of laughing up here, but Coach Pena has got a very high percentage of going for it on fourth down, but apparently not in the mood tonight. It probably has a lot to do with the respect of his opponent.
All right, here we go. It's going to be fourth and call it two, and the Jags will be playing from about their own 27-yard line.
All right, big old Areola. That's the punt. The Dooley. He put his foot into it at the high end over end. Fair catch signal. Caught cleanly at the 30, which is where PSJA is going to take over in their territory.
Pablo, both teams starting their first drive at the 30-yard line. How's that?
Mathematical coincidence.
It is?
Yes, sir.
All right, so it's going to be first and 10 for the Bears. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, in case you just joined us, we did start late. We started about 8:05 here with the kickoff. We've been at it just on the first possession. It was the Jags going 3-and-out, Pablo, and that was after the assistance of a 5-yard penalty against the Bears. It didn't hurt the Bears at all. So it's going to be first and 10 for the Bears. 9:54 left in the first quarter. Once again, we're at Edinburg Cat Stadium. It's Jaguars against the Bears.
All right, Econ looking at double twins. Quarterback in the shotgun, hands off to his running back, instead tailback. De La Cera, but he is hit immediately. Maybe a loss of one. Don't it give
loss
great credit to the D-line of the Econ.
All right, it'll be second and 11 coming up. Both teams not very successful on their first play of the night. It'll be second and 11 coming up for the Bears. 9:35 and counting. Pablo, with this weather, are we going to be looking at a lot of running going on?
There's going to be some slippage, don't it? You know, usually the more wet the situation, the less passing. Of course, that's if it's falling from the sky, but there's no rainfall at this time. Now, the artificial turf is wet, but we've been had rain off and on tonight. A sweep to the left that should have gone outside, got turned inside. Good, great job to Econ defense. A minimal gain of about 3, don't it?
All right, it'll be 2nd and 8. They're calling it 2nd and 7. Picked up the 3 and the 1 that we're back. It's going to be 4-yard pickup on the play. It'll be 3rd and 7 coming up for the Bears, and we're under 9 minutes left in the first quarter. First possession for the Bears.
No huddle for the Bears. Got trips right, split left.
It's kind of Andrew kind of football there. They.
Oh, everybody's in a hurry, don't it?
All right.
Andrew Castañeda at the helm for the Bears. And it's going to be a pass. He rolls out to his right. He's got time. He decides to tuck it under, and he is going to run, and he is not going to get the first down. It's going to be a good 4th and 1.5, 4th and 2, don't it?
4th and 2, just the way the Jags were facing. Same.
What are we going to do?
Scrimmage. They both started at the 30. They both have 4th, and we'll call it a long 1, a short 2 coming up for the Bears. 39,
4th and short. Okay, I see the quarterback going out.
All right.
Okay, so, you know, I don't know who's the punter, but I'll tell you what, the quarterback going out. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean they're going to punt because they could do a wildcat. Here it is.
There it is.
Coach, even the coordinator for Econ said we might see some wildcat. That's pretty much where the quarterback's going to run on his own.
Now he's going to punt it? No.
I don't know. A quick punt. All right, that's not bad. That's a good technique. And that they know that Econ is not going to have anybody back. Great job, ladies and gentlemen. I'll tell you what happened was the Bears line up in the Wildcat.
We got a flag.
They have an athletic, you know, player back there, quarterback. Everybody expected him to run. They do a little audible. He takes a few steps back, turns that into a punt. Econ has nobody back. It takes a gorgeous roll, and Econ is pinned back on their own one.
Are they going to go half the distance?
Here comes the call.
Yeah. Back it up a little bit more.
Yeah.
Can you?
You can.
So it's going to be about.
There it is. Look, he took a little step, a little tiny step.
It's going to be about 99 yards to go. It'll be first and 10 for the Jags. They're inside their own 1 yard line. Pablo.
Bobby going
from the 38 to the 1.
That's pretty darn good. I don't care if you're playing for a New England Patriots or what, but that's going to work.
72 yards.
Bad field position?
Don't step back.
And they're right. He's still on his feet to the 22-yard line.
So for the first time, we're going to move those chains.
An excellent run by Allen Arredondo off the right guard. It was a massive hole. He didn't get touched until 20 yards later, though, and it gained him 22.
Jaguars 25, Allen Arredondo.
Great run.
Move the chains.
They move. They're not going to move. Didn't they rest? Move those chains. Did you hear that? That's our boys. They want some shirts, don't it?
All right, here we go.
All right. In the usual formation, got motion across. It's going to be a dive up the middle and some real good holes. Is that the Dooley?
Yes, sir.
Areola.
9 yards.
Areola got 4 yards before he got contact, and he carried one of the Bears another 4 yards for a gain of about 8 or 9.
Yep, this will be pick up of 9 yards. Bring up a second and one coming up once again. We're at Edinburg Cat Stadium, where it's Jaguar football tonight here in Edinburg. And right now, it's going to be the second time that the Jags touched the ball. The Bears touched the ball one time. They both went 3 and out. The Bears got their first break on a good punt. They set up like they were going to go from the Wildcat. They took a step, good punt. It rolled. It took a bear roll all the way to inside the two, and then they went half the distance on a flag. So Pablo, quickly on the first play, they go for 22 yards, bring it out to the 22. Now it is first, second, and one after 88 came up with 9 yards.
You know, credit to the Econ for their offensive scheme. They have a lot of trickery in the backfield. It requires a lot. A lot of paying attention on the part of the linebackers for the Bears. Every linebacker has to key on a particular back, but when they're crossing each other, it can get interesting, and that's why Econ had a lot of success through the years.
People starting to come in, Pablo.
Yeah, it's not bad. I mean, it's a little muggy here, but it was raining, not anymore. Another dive right up the middle, and he goes at least. Oh, we have a fumble! It is still on the ground. He did run for the first down, but the ball popped out. Let's see who got on it. On the way to Acton, looks like Econ may get on it.
First
and
down!
The Bears are celebrating because they've got the ball. Oh, a little wet ball, a little slippery.
Yeah, I mean, remember the last game we had here when the game delayed? I mean, they were dropping passes at quarterbacks.
At least half passes were dropped.
I mean, a lot of
bobble, snap, everything.
Everything was happening. So it's going to be the first turnover, and it's going to come with 6:42 left in the first quarter. Econ, after starting inside their own one, came up all the way to the 43-yard line. That's their own 43, and they fumbled the ball. PSJA comes up with it. It'll be first and 10. The Bears already in Jaguar territory.
It's unfortunate for the Jaguars because they were really driving. I mean,
momentum was great there.
Positive gains and all the runs. Here we go. Double twins. Looks like it's going to be a run. Hand off right up the gut. A little shoestring tackle by Jaguar, by Econ, and if he didn't get him, he's running for another 10, don't it? So, game of two. Good job,
Econ. 2 yards, number 21. Give me a name on that one.
Oh, you got that. That's their Ryan Latta carrying the rock for the Bears right up the cut. Quick, no huddle. Double twins. Andrew Castaneda getting the audible from the sideline. Coach over there for the Bears. Coach Marikis. And he's Andrew Castaneda with the ball. He's going to roll out to his left. And he's got a man open in the flats. And he overthrows him. He had his receiver, Jacob Barrera, ran about 10 yards and then out. And he was wide open, Dylan. All he had to do was catch it at the first down for sure. And unfortunately for the Bears, Andrew Castaneda overthrew him by about 2 yards.
All right, it's going to be big third and 8. Pablo, 2-down territory?
I say so, yes, sir.
Why pin him back inside the one? They're going to run it out of there anyway.
I think they're getting the impression that Econ's going to be running on them tonight.
Okay, so here we go. 3rd and 8 coming up. Ball at the 41-yard line.
Trips right, split left if you're Econ. Because he has a shotgun. He's going to roll out to his left again. He throws on the run. He's got a man open in the middle. And he overthrew him again.
He got hit.
Yes, quarterback Castaneda, and he knew he was going to get hit too. So you got to give him credit. He rolls to his left, sets up to throw, and as he's releasing the ball, he got plowed into. And maybe that resulted in a errant throw, but he did take a hit, and he's back on his feet.
All right, same guy coming out that ran the Wildcat for them here. Maybe they're going to try to do the same thing. Maybe we see something. He's going to try and do something. Here we go, Pablo. It's going to be 4th and 8 coming up. Ball at the 41-yard line of the Jags. Uh-oh.
Oh, they tried to get him outside.
He did.
And he throws. He's got a man deep down the sideline. Anthony Dunaway. What happened?
Overthrown. You overthrew him. About a yard.
What I mean, what happened is he had 5 yards on the defender. And Anthony Dunaway had at least 5 yards on the defender. And it was just way overthrown.
Good thing for the Jags. It's only going to give them 5 yards, so it's still going to be 4th down, but it'll be 4th and 3, and the ball will be inside the 37-yard line, I believe, here, Paulo. We'll wait and see where they're going to spot the ball. Now, do you bring back your quarterback, Paulo, or we stick to the same thing?
Well, you know, we've seen 3 different quarterbacks to this point.
Okay.
They have their traditional pocket passer. They're looking at Bobby Guajardo in there again. He was in there a while. He's the one they punted earlier. Okay, so I'm sure he's kind of thinking about that right now.
All right, 4th and 3. We're down to 5:51 left in the first quarter. We're still scoreless here at Edinburg Cat Stadium.
And he's going to keep it himself. He's got a lead blocker. He's got the outside. There's a flag. He's on the 20, the 10, and he is knocked out, but there is a flag on the play. A great run and a keeper by Bobby Guajardo off the left guard.
Pushing the back.
Bounces outside.
There's a flag on the play, though. Coach wanted an explanation on who it was. Here goes.
It looks like Coach Monique for the Bears is very upset. Obviously they're going to go against the Bears. After a gorgeous run by Guajardo to the left side.
Twice, Pablo, they let him get away. Then the first one was a pass. If he had caught that one, that would have stand there because the flag was against the Jaguars. Nevertheless, he went down to the 6-yard line. They're going to bring it back. Mm. It's going to be pushing the back, I believe, on the Bears.
That's a 10.
So instead of 4th and 3. Well, the flag was thrown at about the 33-yard line anyway, so it's still going to bring them back to maybe 4th and 8 coming up. We'll wait and see.
There you go.
They're trying to spot the ball. There you go.
Yeah, they got to figure out where.
From the 34?
There we go. Marking it off.
Oh, from right the 35. There.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See, are you going to go 10, ladies and gentlemen?
10, yeah.
10. What?
15.
Okay, must be something else.
Yeah.
Yeah, they haven't gotten the signal yet.
Clip?
And maybe it may have been a crackback. I saw someone just get absolutely chopped on the outside, which probably resulted in why he got so open.
So it's going to be 4th and 18 coming up.
All right, Twins left, but right. It's strong left if you're Econ by virtue of the tight end on the left side. Tight end on the left side with two additional wide receivers. And it's going to be a quick punt, and it's going to be just like it was last time. It takes a bare hop, and it's going to go into the end zone this time.
Bobby Guajardo.
And looks like Econ's going to get the ball on the 20.
Yeah, it'll be 1st and 10 for Econ, and it'll be the third time they touch the ball. The Bears have touched it twice. Pablo, we had one first down picked up, and that is by Econ. Then they picked up 9, and then a big run for another 10 or 11, but the fumble came in after that. So we've had one first down, Pablo, not the best kind of football.
Yeah, we're kind of grinding it out. Both teams, now, of course, Econ was really starting to drive here a minute ago, but for the miscue on the fumble, they had nothing but a 20-yard gain, 10, 6, 8, and then the miscue on the fumble, see what they come out with.
All right, here we go. 1st and 10 for Jackson at their own 20-yard line. Pablo,
it's going to be a dive off the left guard. Again, plenty of room as the line gets a great surge and a gain of 7 off the left side. A gorgeous run by Adorondo.
All right, it'll be 7 yards on that play. It'll be 2nd and 3 coming up for the Jags. We're down to under 5 minutes left in the first quarter, ladies and gentlemen. It's Donut and Paul coming to you from Edinburg Cat Stadium, and we're still scoreless with the Jags and the Bears.
Okay, if you're the Bears, you're looking at strong right. your econ, you're pretty strong on the left.
And fumble!
A mishandled snap. Looks like the quarterback, David Garcia, was able to get on it. But again, maybe a wet ball, don't it?
Paul, I mean, we saw this last week. You know, same kind of game, same delay. We were started an hour late, 30 minutes late like last week. And to me, it seems like this turf, it drained well, apparently. But these balls, they seem to have stayed wet.
But, you know, there's only
get them on the field.
There's only a certain number of balls, don't it? I mean, they don't get a brand new ball every play. Eventually, the balls are going to get wet. I mean, they do their best they can to dry them off. Here we go. Trickery. Got to go outside to Jesse Gonzalez.
Nowhere.
As he gets swarmed, maybe back to the line of scrimmage, as he was wanting to get outside. But give credit to the Bear defense for not only not letting them outside, but the pursuit got there like it's supposed to, like it's supposed to be designed. Great defense.
So once again, it's going to be three and out. Last time they ran only three plays, also probably because they picked up the first down on the long play, then pick up 9 yards, and then the fumble. So they got their average. In three plays every possession, they get the ball. That's the Jags.
The Dooley, Adeola back to punt. All they do is just get that big old leg moving. I'm sure that ball's going to be gone. It is a good snap. He's got it cleanly. He takes a big step. Hits a good high floater. Fair catch by the Bears. Fair caught by Nathan Cifuentes as the Bears are going to take over on the 41. Their own 41.
Their own 41. It'll be first and 10 for the Bears. We're at 3:35 after the first quarter, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, special thanks going out to Cat TV 17. That is KATS Channel 17, of course, Valley Central. That is KTVT Channel 4. We also like to thank our board that made this possible for us in agreeing and doing this deal with ValleyCentral.com, and that is the Board of Trustees, our President Juan Sonny Palacios, Vice President Dr. Martin Castillo, Secretary Jaime Solis, and of course our members, Jaime Chavana, Carmen Gonzalez, Robert Peña Jr., and David Torres. Pablo, sorry about that.
That's all right, sir, because you're talking about some good folks there. Read option, quarterback read option, as he decides to keep it himself and go off the left guard tackle for a gain of three.
All right, it'll be second and seven. And we mentioned these board members, and let's give a little special thanks going out, of course, to Jaime Chavana, who's leaving the board after 12 years, and David Torres, who's leaving after the board after 8 years. Special thanks going out to Mr. Chavana and Mr. Torres for all that time that they took away from their family and family time to take care of business for the ECISD. So once again, Mr. Torres, Mr. Chavana, thank you very much. We're down to 257 in county, folks. We're still scoreless here at Denver Cat Stadium. I'm Dorn Salinas. To my right, Paul Osberry.
Troy Flores in the shotgun. Give it to his tailback as he cuts back to the right. He bounces it back outside. And he fumbles Mark Castillo. A good run. A tough run to the right side. And he lost the ball but recovered.
So for the first time in the PSJA, man, we're going to move those chains.
Good run by Mark Castillo as he got forced back inside, bounced it back outside, and took a hit. Ball popped out, but obviously recovered by PSJ Bears first down.
All right, then we started at their own 41. Now they're at the 41-yard line of the Jags.
Yep, they're moving it.
Here we go, Pablo.
You got Troy Flores back in shotgun, two tailbacks on the right left hip. It's going to be a handoff, and he has got absolutely nowhere to go. Andrew De La Cerda, their senior star running back, a loss of two at the D-line, pitched in, don't it? And there was no holes there.
They gave him a loss of one only there, Pablo. Another good forward progress call by the ref there. So it's going to be second and 11 coming up. We're under 2 minutes before this play gets off left in the first quarter. We're still scoreless here at Cat Stadium.
I'll tell you what, the defensive line clearly pinched inward. Maybe the coordinator knows something we don't know, but they basically took care of, for between tackle and tackle, there was no room. Here we go. Back in the shotgun once again. It's a quick pass to the right. Oh, he somehow makes a grab. Anthony Dunaway, we thought it was going to be a pick. The corner stepped up, and I may have just gone through his hands, but give credit to Dunaway for maintaining concentration, making the grab, turning the field. A solid gain of about 20, and they're going to
move those chains. It'll be first and 10 for the Bears, and they gain into the red zone. Ball at the 19-yard line, 1:39 and counting left in the first quarter.
Wow, we thought that corner, it was basically a five-yard curl, and the corner just broke on it beautifully. I think it went through his hands. But again, Dunaway made a great grab.
All right, here we go.
Troy Flores, it's going to be a quarterback keep up the middle, read option, very quick. He's still on his feet. Troy Flores faked the sweep to the left, decided to keep it, go up off left tackle, and went untouched for about 10 yards and carried a few guys for 15, and they're going to
move those chains and drop them chains. It'll be first and goal for the PSJA Bears, and quickly they start at their own 41-yard line. About six, 7 plays later, it is going to be first and goal. Ball will be at the 4-yard line.
I'll tell you what, great run right there. A little shout out to my boy Ed Rios. He's we'll get to you. We'll get to your shout out here in a minute.
Louis, Danny, all them Rios?
Yeah, all the Rios family, man. Some good folks from Edinburg. Oh, look at that. Absolutely nothing as the Economedies defense brought everybody up the middle. I guess they're expecting a run. And not only were they expecting it, they took care of it for a loss of 2, second and goal.
Second and goal. Ball's now at the 6-yard line. And the Bears kind of...
Keep people fresh.
That's
right. We see a lot of substitution on the line, tight end. A little shout out to my boy Ed Rios in our fantasy football league, the REL. His team is called You a Good Team, and he is 0-1. Ed, thanks for tuning in. He's over there in Austin through RobbieTimes.com. All right, shotgun dive right up the middle at the head. You know, a real tough run, but he ran smack into a wall right there. Econ held it for a gain of 2. Third and what?
They're putting the ball right at the 3-yard line, Paolo. So it's a pickup of 3 yards. And it's going to be
that third
and goal.
That quarter.
And it's going to go. After 1 quarter of play, we have the Bears touching the ball 3 times. They picked up 2 first downs. I'm sorry. They got 2 first downs. And they're knocking on the door there at the 3-yard line. It is third and goal from the 3. On their side, the Jags have picked up 1 first down. They had something going with a pickup, a run of 22 yards. Then they picked up 9 yards. On the next play, they had about another 11 or 12 yards, but the fumble came in. And that gave the Bears the ball. They held the Bears one more time, but after the Bears punted, it was the Jags going 3 and out one more time. So it's going to be the Bears knocking on the door. They're going to start the second quarter. They're knocking, Pablo?
Oh, yes, sir. You can hear them.
No doorbell?
Yeah, the doorbell, please. You know the old knock-knock joke? You got a knock-knock joke for me? Just start it. Say knock-knock.
Knock-knock.
Come in. Took care of that joke right
there. Right. You're kidding me, Paolo.
So that's the Bears. They are knocking on the door.
You think the Jags are going to say come in?
No, sir.
No.
That's why they haven't answered, don't it? It's got triple locks. You know the lock on the top?
Deadbolt.
Yeah, deadbolt. You don't even have a key from the other. All right, here we go. Quick huddle, eye formation. Matter of fact, it's so quick.
I don't think they were ready.
The Bears basically huddled up and broke the huddle, and they didn't get everybody set.
The refs weren't ready.
Yeah, the referees were not able. You know, the referees have a lot of things they got to do pre-snap. They got to count the lines on the line. They got to make sure everybody's ready. And the Bears were so quick, they got ahead of the refs.
All right, so we'll just do it again. The clock didn't even move, man. They were that fast.
I'll tell you what, they wouldn't hurry up. They got it. They're doing it again, and they break the huddle very quickly. As Troy Flores under the center, hands it off to the right, left side, and
touchdown!
As De La Zeta just basically trots in on the left side, just like that, 6-0.
All right, that 6 points was only 4 seconds into the second quarter, and the Bears on the first play go the 3 yards, and quickly now it is the Bears 6, the Jags 0, and we're waiting for the point after bubble.
Hey, I'll tell you what, some good play calling by the Bears. They've been running it up the gut, and that play was designed to go outside, and he went untouched.
Snap is up,
and he keeps his head down. Looks good from here. Extra point, Bears!
So with the first play in the second quarter, it's going to be the PSJA Bears 7 and the Economedes Jaguars 0. Paulo, I mean,
look at the folks. We got some folks here tonight.
Yeah, they're getting here, Paulo. They're getting here. And you got to be proud of that, Paulo. You know, you don't know if there's going to be a game or not. It was pouring.
Oh my God.
Lightning, thunder, and they find out there was going to be a game. And you know what? The people are coming out.
Build it, and they will come.
The fans are all four schools.
You're right about that.
The Bobcats.
You're right about
Bobcat
that.
Bobcat pride is back. The Sabercats are just loading it up. The Cougars have their fans. And the Jags, look at them on a rainy day. They're still here.
You know, let me finish a little shout-out. Unfortunately, my boy Ed Rios lost connection. He's back on the computer. my boy Ed Rios. You know a bunch of those Rioses from Edinburg.
Danny, Louis.
Oh, yeah, Louis. Danny Louis operated on my arm, man. Louis, plastic surgeon. Yeah, great job. My boy Ed, a little shout-out. He's listening in Austin, Texas. I'm glad you're back on. A little computer glitch. Good to hear you. My boy Bill Reynolds. He's just on his computer. We can probably see his house from here. appreciate you, Bill. Daggers. Glad you're listening as well through ValleyCenter.com.
All right, here we go. It's going to be them coming up on the 40-yard line. They're kicking to the north.
A low, short kick. Going to give an opportunity to the Econ as he returns the catch on the 11. He goes down the left side. He had a man to beat, and it looked like there was a little bit of room, but not anymore. Down on the 30.
30, not bad field position there, Paul. That's a good average. You know, start at the 30, not bad. All you got is about 70 yards to go, and you tie up the game. We'll wait what's going to happen. But, Pablo, they had a good drive going up to that fumble, and then they just didn't seem to get going again once they got the ball again. So PSJA got good field position, and they jumped on it. Took advantage of that, and they started throwing 41 quickly. Two plays, they were at the 41-yard line of the Jags, and they continued going in for the score. So it's going to be right now the PSJA Bears 7 and the Jaguars 0. We're at 11:48. We just started the second quarter, ladies and gentlemen. We're on a rain delay, but we finally got going. I think things cleared up for us, Pablo.
You're right about that. It's definitely clear. Of course, the field's wet. You know, artificial turf's going to be just fine. Excellent play calling by the Bears, Coach Mato Keene, and that had a lot to do with the coaching staff in that last touchdown. Here we go. Econ breaks the huddle in their traditional formation. And it's going to be a dive off the right side. Absolutely no room. He is suffocated immediately. Maybe a loss of one, don't it?
Yeah, better to get him back to the line.
Running with the ball is 25, Allen Adebondo.
It'll be second and 10, call it. They gave him the spot right back to the line scrimmage. It'll be 10-10, 11:30 and running second quarter. Once again, you're listening to Catch TV 17. Of course, you'll watch it later. You're just listening right now. Due to UIL, you cannot see a live game on a Friday night. So it's going to be just the audio coming to you from Donut and Paul.
All right, Econ. Going to hand it off up the gut, off the left side. Is that the Diesel?
Yes, sir.
Ariola.
Ariola, the Diesel, again moving the pile. He was hit about 1 yard after the line.
Lost the helmet.
And lost his helmet and continued to drag people for another couple yards, a gain of about four.
Big boy.
Oh, the Dooley.
It'll be third and 6 coming up for the Jags. Pablo.
What's that kind of hit you have inside the bed of the truck? The
gooseneck.
Gooseneck. He's got a gooseneck back there. Dooley. What?
The fifth wheel.
Fifth wheel. Thank you very much. The boys back here in the booth. And looks like he's going to be a sweep to the left. And he's got a blocker. He's got the edge. Can he get it? A tough run as he lowers his head. Let me get a number on that.
All right. They're calling the timeout. He didn't go out of bounds, but they're going to call a timeout so we can move those chains.
Rudy Castillo on that tough run. He lowered his head, ladies and gentlemen. He needed one more yard. And him and the defensive back went head to head. And Rudy Castillo got that extra yard. And you've heard us already. Move those chains. You know what that means. First down, Econ.
All right. It'll be first and 10. 10-17 and counting left. The ball is at the 47-yard line on the Jags side of the field.
Econ in a traditional formation. It's going to be lost the ball as a mishandled handoff. It looked like the running back, tailback, was a little bit too close to the quarterback. Somehow, luckily, they got back on it. Certainly luckily if you're for Econ, but it resulted in a loss of one.
It'll be second 11 coming up, 9:15 counting. It's still the PSJA Bears 7 and the Jaguars from Economy is 0. Pablo, it seems like this is a game not starting on time. These kids kind of get thrown off.
A little bit out of whack.
And the band wasn't here. The band just setting up right now, getting here. So, I mean, it's going to take a while maybe for the Jacks to get going. Here we go.
A sweep to the left side. Great defensive stance by the Bears. And a tough run. What could have, should have been maybe a back to the line of scrimmage. Turned to a positive gain of about 7. What a great run by Jesse Gonzalez. Great run.
Yeah, they needed 11. They got 7. So it's going. Third and caught it a long, short four, long three. Here we go. It's going to be Economia's ball. Now they're on the Bears side of the field at the 48-yard line.
Good job by the Bears. The big boy, Raymond Valero, as he turned the run inside. It's a very good technique. Great job by the Bears defense, especially by Valero.
A little better job being done there by the running boys. They had him run for 2 yards.
Yes, and a tough run, don't it? You're right. And it's going to be another run off the left guard. And he gets about
where he needed to. Timeout. Timeout.
Yeah, looks like it's a first down, don't it?
I'm calling the first down.
I'm calling it too. Oh, we're on the same. Don't it? Hey, you owe me some nachos, man.
I know.
You're in the hole. One order of nachos, no jalapenos.
All right, here we go. First down. So one more time. Move those chains. Pablo, that's a big first down they picked up.
They're driving it.
That's their second one already here. So that's first down number three. And, Paul, what, I mean, the best thing to do is, you know, score and do something after the PSJA scored. You held it one time, and you couldn't do nothing, but now you got the ball again. Maybe they're going
to
do something.
They'd love to answer the call, don't it? Econ, all right, if you're the Bears. Oh, and we have the right card.
65.
Yep, got a little antsy and moved. How about a little shout-out? My boy Mata, Kyle Flanagan, he is a good man. That's all I got to say about that.
Kyle?
Kyle Flanagan, all of them, good folks. Kyle out there listening in Austin, Texas, otherwise known as Mata in the REG. What?
Kyle, class of 82?
Kyle Flanagan, man, we love you, man. All and, right. Thank you for tuning in to ValleyCentral.com, Kyle.
All right, it's going to be first and 15 coming up. 8:18 left, ladies and gentlemen, in the half. And it's still the Bears over the Jags, 7-0.
All right, strong left if you're the Bears. And it looks like it's going to be a play-action pass. He's got a man. He's got a step on him. He makes the catch on the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Jags!
Oh, my God. Did you set up with all that running?
Yeah, set it up. It was gorgeous, ladies and gentlemen. Play-action pass, don't it?
Yeah, you got to see this, ladies and gentlemen.
Across the formation. So the flags and pass drew up who should have been covering that deep third, and he had at least two steps on the safety. All it took was a good throw, and that's why we're screaming touchdown Jaguars.
And Bob, we talked about it. You know, like I said, to me it threw him off. That starting at 7:30, the band not playing, things like that. To me, it just, you got to refocus and get ready for a game at a different time, and they just did that right now.
Oh, I don't know how that wasn't. Let me tell you what, though. Christian Sanchez came up the middle. I think he came up to block it. He was so close to the kicker. I think it went between his legs. I'm serious, don't it? I think it went under him.
Can we get a replay maybe on that?
Yeah, Perry. Really? Yeah, Perry. They have an older brother, Ken. Yeah, they're good folks, man.
That's the Flanagans?
Yep. There's some good people. Looks like you got all tied up at 7-7, don't it?
We're tied up with 8:10 left in the half. The Jags come back. And remember, they scored with 11:56. It only took them about 3 minutes to come back and answer the call. So it's the Jags on the board now. So, ladies and gentlemen, with 8:10, we got a new ball game here at Edinburg Cat Stadium. You're listening to Team Donut and Paul. I'm Donut Salinas. To my right, Paul Osbury. So with 8:10 left in the half, it is now Economedies Jaguars 7, PSJA Bears 7.
And for all of you, you know, football, you know, coaches out there, a little bit of terminology. They sent out it was only a one man route.
One man.
One guy going for the pass. But you know, good play action will take care of that, and you see the result is 7-7.
All right, Pablo, I think this is gonna determine how this game's gonna go. If you can do something here,
Jose Valle put his foot into it, he kicks it kind of short to the right, give you the econ, and it's being brought back. He had nowhere to go because he's got nothing but orange jerseys all around him, and he is suffocated.
Watch it.
On the 14-yard line. Econ playing very hard on the kickoff. Great job by the coverage team.
So they only got to the 15, they're calling it the 14-yard line. So, Pablo, the momentum can take a big shift right here. The crowd is starting to completely get here. Everybody that's coming to the game, the band is ready. And I think the Jags just got ready themselves. It's going to be first and 10 for the Bears. They got 86 yards to go.
That was Troy Flores on the return. A minimal gain. Great job by the special teams, by Economedies. Everybody staying in their lanes, don't it? Everybody, you know, nobody got influenced in one direction or the other. And so they worked on as a team on that one. You know, you're to my left, you're to my right, I'm in the middle, bam.
All right, here we go. No huddle. They just came out from the coaches gathering over there, and it's going to be first and 10 for the Bears. 8 minutes left.
Nathan Cifuentes. And we have all kinds of movement as the Bears, clearly illegal procedure. That's Troy Fuller in the backfield. I apologize.
Can we check Leo, see if he's got the name of the referees? All right, so it's going to be 5 yards back. That's another flag. That's going to be the third flag against the Bears, and it's going to be 15 yards total. You know, the Jaguars have one flag. for 1 yard.
That's pretty good. The distance. You know, when you're playing a tough opponent, you know, all these little things matter. You know, field position, penalties, and right now it's pushing them back as they're, you know, back there on their nine. Here we go. It's going to be a quarterback keeper.
Fumble!
They stripped him. Econ immediately, like a team of America, Econ stripped the ball. They got
Edward
Silva
So quickly after two plays, they stripped the ball from the quarterback. He kept it. And then, oh, you can kind of see this guy swinging at him.
We saw it. Mark Castillo, unfortunately, coughs up the rock, but that's all due to economy of defense. Clearly, they were stripping the ball, don't it? And that's great defensive technique.
All right, so it's going to be first and 10. And we're going to have to change up, Paula, because it's at the 11-yard line. So possible first down could be picked up by the Jags.
You're right about that. Hey, let a shout out to my brother from the same mother, which is my brother. Borrachos, listen to San Antonio, the commissioner of the Rugby League, Robert Aldsbury, otherwise known as Jody. That's my brother. He's listening on valleycentral.com.
Where's he at, Pablo?
He's in San Antonio. Yes, sir. Listening in. Want to say hello. He told us, he said, hey, he said, yo, to the Move the Chains boys. That's us. And sometimes it is. But really, that's us, though.
Yeah.
Bro, love you. You know the deal.
All right.
We had an injured player.
Yeah, he's up on his own. He's up on his own. They're helping him out a little bit, so that's good news for the Bears. But the bad news is they turned the ball over at their own 11-yard line, so the Jags getting a little birthday give on 9-12.
Yes, sir. Just like that, we caught Economedies in scoring position. Give credit to the defense. You know, good job for, you know, defending the corner. People like Coach Jaime Olivares, I'm sure that's instilled in the kids. You know, strip it. Go for the ball if you can. And they did. Econ. Snap is up. It's a dive. Lavadondo goes off the left tackle. Still on his feet, dragging a few guys down to the 4-yard line. A tough run by Lavadondo.
Pick up of 7 yards. It'll be a second and third coming up. Ball at the 4-yard line, just inside the 5 for the Jaguars. We're down to 7:35 and count, ladies and gentlemen. And it's the Jags trying to go ahead here. And this game is locked up at 7 right now. Pablo.
There is blood in the water, and the Jaguars.
Oh, quick shot.
Lavadondo. That wasn't to a pile. Man, they're going to have a very generous forward progress spot. Looks to be a gain of another about 2, and they got about 3rd and 1.
Paulo, they just got there, they set up, and bang, they went quick play there.
Yes, they did. And
3rd and call it 1 coming up for the Jags. Ball is at the 2-yard line of the PSJA Bears.
Adedondo running very tough. Just ran headlong into a pile.
Quarterback Zeke.
Areola and Arredondo. Areola, the lead blocker.
Fumble.
Oh, somehow the ball was fumbled. I don't know what happened. I thought it was handed off to I don't know, don't it? Somehow, some way.
PSJA Bear football.
Miscue by the quarterback at the handoff. And just like that, the Bears have hopped on it, and they will say, thank you very much.
Wow, Paul. I mean, that's got to be frustrating on the Jaguars side of the field. And again, Paul, when you're that close, why run back with the ball? But, I mean, hey, I don't coach, so. But I thought he was just going to, you know, quarterback sneak. I mean, why move backwards?
Well, you know, that's the type of running play.
And it was a fake to the handoff, wasn't it? He never gave it to him, apparently.
I think what happened was the quarterback handed it to him, and he realized, wait a second, that didn't go very cleanly. He started looking around for the ball, and that's when everybody realized, oh, boy, you know what? We don't have it. But I'll tell you what, who did have it was the Bears.
All right, it'll be 1st and 10. They're at their own 5-yard line.
All right, looking at De La Cerda standing in the end zone as the Bears are backed up, motion across the formation. It is going to be, hands to the right side, a nifty run by Christian Sanchez.
Fumble!
Another fumble! It could be hopped on by the Economies. Oh, they're knocking it down. Another fumble.
Paul,
yes.
The ball has to be, I mean, second game.
It has to be.
This rain happens, this weather comes through us here in Edinburg, and we're having the same result for both games.
Christian Sanchez off the right side, a nifty gain of about 5 yards, and just as he's about to get tackled, the ball pops out. And I think Economy recovered it, but the player that recovered it had his body partially out of bounds, so he was out of bounds, and by virtue, the ball is down, and they were not able to gain possession because he was out of bounds.
Timeout, PSJA. It'll be 2nd and 5 when we come back and start with the live action. For right now, Pablo, not the games we've been seeing in Edinburgh.
Well, we've been privy to some. You know, we're 4-1 in this stadium right here, and you know we just saw Vela put up 59 points last night, just scoring at will. And so you're seeing a real good battle, clearly a battle of minds with the Econ versus the Bears. I'll tell you what, I could tell it's very good play calling, don't it? And very disciplined ball. Both teams are making some mistakes, but both teams are also playing a very good defense.
All right, that's hearing it from Paul Osbury. Once again, it's Paul Osbury and Don Salinas coming to you from Edinburg, Cat Stadium. In case you're just joining us, it was a scoreless first quarter with only 4 seconds into the second quarter. It was PSJ getting on the board. 3 minutes later, it was the Jags coming back and getting on the board. Then on the next possession, the Bears fumbled the ball at the 11-yard line, but the Jaguars do them the favor and fumble the ball at the 2-yard line. So it's PSJA on a second and 5 coming up from the 10.
Pablo Hood is going to keep it himself.
Ooh.
And what there you there was a hole, but just like that, the hole was done. And maybe a gain of one, 34.
Third and four coming up. Big third down coming up. Jaguars could have good, strong defense right here and change the momentum right back to their side.
Yep. Floyd is running the quarterback read option. That's where the quarterback has the option as he studies one of the particular defenders and he can decide, do I want to keep it, do I want to get it? And he kept it, and only a gain of one. Floyd is back in the shotgun. And it's going to be a quarterback sweep. He does have a good lead block, but he could not get past the secondary. Give credit to the corner for Economedes for shedding the receiver, coming up and cutting him in a great defensive stance. Fourth down.
Fourth and two coming up. They'll be setting up at their own 13-yard line. They need to get to the 15.
I'll tell you what, I don't got a number on that on the left corner for Econ, but I'll tell you what. Woo-wee, that's how you play defense, I'll tell you that.
All right, here we go. It's going to be a punt, and it's coming out from about the 3-yard line, maybe the 4-yard line, Pablo, and he's just going to go sideways once again.
I don't know. We're seeing some shifting around on the returners for Econ.
Timeout.
Yeah, a little bit of confusion on both sides.
Do they have enough guys? Let me see. 1, 2, 3.
A little bit of confusion.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 guys on
yeah.
the field.
You can see a little bit of confusion, and, of course, the coach, certainly the Bears, picked up on
there
it.
There you go. There's the last guy.
Yeah, hey, yeah. Welcome to the game, buddy. That does. It always frustrates the coach, you know. Give credit to Coach Marroquin for noticing that, and instead of, you know, moving him further back, you know, it's the first half. Use it as a wise timeout. Let's regroup, talk about it, make sure we have our men. Let's get that one out.
Pablo, I thought we were going to start district next week. We have one more preseason. They got 4 games preseason, then they go with district.
I'm loving it. We are loving it.
Yeah, it's been good. It's been good. And Pablo, just to and Pablo, I can't wait to see the Bobcats again, man.
Not only Bobcats, but I want to see the Texas State Bobcats tomorrow night. Sold out crowd, Texas State versus Navy, my alma mater. I'll be there in San Marcos tomorrow.
Wow, have a safe trip, buddy.
I will. Thank you, sir. I'll try. All right, Bears in punt formation. Got the signal for the snap. Snap is up. It's a very good snap. He's got plenty of time. It's a low line drive. He's going to be fielded cleanly at the 40. He gets cut back. And just like that. It's picked up by the Bears, and he runs it down to the 40, the 35. And again, a very costly mistake. It would have been a good return. He gets spun around, gets hit on the elbow. Ball pops out. Bears catch it on the run. Just like that, Bears ball.
Yes, it sure is. So instead of it being the Economedes Jaguars football at about the 42-yard line of the Bears, it's going to be first and 10 for the Bears, and they're at the 34-yard line of the Jaguars. Second turnover.
Someone dry those balls off. What is going on?
I'm telling you, Pablo.
Ball just popped out. Boom. Heads up by the Bear, basically on the punt team to pick scoop it up.
Special teams are doing good.
There's no doubt.
There we go. First and 10.
Double twins. Floyd is in the shotgun. It's a read option. And he ran it wrong because he headed into a tailback for a loss of 3. There was 3 economy. These guys took care of that. Loss of 2 or maybe 3.
Yeah. It'll be second and 13 coming up. 4:20 and counting left in the half. And it is still the Jaguars from Economedes 7 and the Bears from PSJA 7.
Floyd is on the read option. I think he was on the wrong page.
Did you see your shirt?
I know. He got the shirt. I like the shirts. I love it.
All right, here we go, Pablo. Second and 13 coming up. We're under 4 minutes left in the half, ladies and gentlemen. It's Donald and Paul bringing the action from Edinburg Cat Stadium.
Econ, double twins.
Fumble!
And a bad snap. It was missed.
Again!
Another fumble just like that.
It's going to be
Jaguar football.
What
What is going on, Joe?
I don't know about this turf, man. I mean, we love it.
Is the water coming up from the ground or what? So what happened, ladies and gentlemen, a snap that hit the quarterback, throwing it in the hands, and he was not able to handle the snap, and it bounced around.
They're falling on it and keep coming out. Both teams had it for, I would say, a split second, then the ball was still coming out. So it's going to be now. First 10 for the Jags. They got good field position. They're starting once again at the 41.
Wow. Here we go. Quick huddle. Split left, split right. I mean, one receiver on either side. It's going to be a run up the middle. Great defensive stance. That's a defensive end for the Bears. I got number 22, Christian Sanchez. Great job to pinch it inside.
First time they hold him to no yards at the diesel. They stopped him.
I'm not sure. Was that the diesel?
Yes, sir. I'm sure it was.
Well, good job by the defensive end. I'm sorry. I got the number wrong. I looked at maybe Jonathan. No. I don't know. But, oh, here we go. 29. No, I don't know. But anyway, the Bears defender, great job for him. The
89, Pablo.
89, I'm sorry, big boy. Raymond Valero, you may hear him tonight. He's a big boy, no doubt. Defensive end in a two-point stance. Here we go. It's going to be play-action pass. He's got a couple of guys wide open, but he's flushed it out of the pocket. He's got nowhere to go. He had two men extremely wide open, but to no avail because the Bear defensive line shoved him out of the pocket, and as he tried to gain his feet to throw, he was hit.
He lost the 7. Pablo, call it a 3rd and 17 coming up for the Jaguars. We're under 2:45 and counting, ladies and gentlemen. We're still locked up at 7. That's PSJA 7, Jaguars 7.
Play action pass. Resulted in several wide open receivers doing it, but he was flushed out of his pocket to his right. Yeah, flushed out of his pocket to the right. And for a quarterback, as he runs to the right, he needed to throw back to his left. He had to get his feet set. And as soon as he did that, bam, he got nailed.
Jags will use their timeout with 1 second left in the play clock. And Paul, really then what I saw Mr. Coach Pena doing is, he goes, I'm going to try and get the first down. And if I don't, I want to leave less time on the clock for the Bears to try and score themselves. So that's a good thinking there of the coaches, Coach Pena, being in the game and realizing, hey, I don't need much time to score, but they don't need to have that much time either. They're going to get the ball back. So good timeout there, and good thing to let the time run down to 1 second left to play clock before we call the timeout. So with 8:21, we have a timeout on the field, and that's being called by the Jags. They have a 3rd and 17. Ball is at their own 39-yard line. Pablo.
Ooh, man, it's just hard to keep, the possessions are changing, economy of ball. You got to go up and get a soda. By the time you come back, it's Bears ball. Then you sneeze, you come back up. Economy of ball, what? I mean, that's the way it's been going tonight.
Yeah, it sure has. And then it's the way it went last time when we had that rain 2 weeks ago, I believe it was. But I guess it's going to happen every time it rains here in Edinburg. There we go.
We've seen that now. Two rainy nights and a lot of fumbles. Here we go. Double twins for the Jaguars. He's got a little bit of time. He feels the heat, and he puts it out of the pocket again. And another sack. He did have enough time, but he was held onto it too long. That was basically a coverage sack, don't it?
As 9 yards.
Receivers were covered.
A loss of another 9 yards, so it's going to be 4th and Las Milpas.
Las Milpas.
4th and PSJ Bear High School.
You got it.
It's going to be 4th and call it 25 coming up for the Jaguars. 1:50 left, and it's going to be the diesel putting.
The diesel, just get that leg moving. Inertia's going to make that ball go, I'm sure. I don't know. Adeola, I'm sorry, back in punt formation. And he's got the signal to his snapper. It's a good snap. He puts his foot into it and hits an end over end. It's going to be fielded. Oh, it takes a bear hop.
Oh!
And, there you go. All right, the ball hit the ground and popped straight up in the air. Nobody knew what direction it was going to hop. It did bounce backwards, then bounce forward. And Economedes probably could have let it go a few yards. Bottom line is no return, and Bears ball on the 34.
Spun the ball right at the 33-yard line, Pablo. So it's going to be 1st and 10 for the Bears. They're at their own 33-yard line, and they have 1:26 to go before halftime. They got one timeout left, Pablo.
I'll tell you what, this game is going very fast because both these teams like to grind it out on the ground. And what, like you said,
50 minutes? We've been playing 50 minutes.
Yes, pretty much a half.
Yeah.
So Bears come out the field. It looks like we have Flores in the shotgun. Flores alongside, not sure, looks like Julian Garza in the backfield on his right side, his right hip. Snap is up. I'm sorry, De La Senna. It's a quick pass to the right as he cuts across the formation in the middle and he goes up to center. Oh! Ooh, what do you say to that, Donut? You call it. You got it, Donut. You made the call. You got it, brother.
Wow.
Okay, let me try. Okay, you got a quick slant on the right from the Bears. Quarterback hits him in stride, and he's going up the middle and comes into traffic. Then coughs another fumble, but yet a Bears receiver catches the fumble on the run.
Perfect hop.
On the perfect hop on the run, proceeds to run it down to the 1 yard line. And just like that, you know the coach didn't draw that up like that. Bottom line, is there at the one.
It's going to be first and goal. Ball at the 1 yard line for PSJA. We're down to 105 and counting left in the half. Timeout being called, and it's going to be the final timeout for PSJA with 102 left.
And, you know, tough. That's tough. There's just some tough breaks tonight. You know, both teams, I'm sure.
Yeah, they're upset.
Both teams.
That is the defense, right?
Yes, sir. Both teams upset. We just had some of the Economedies coaches up there in the booth walk by, and they're not in a good mood as the Bears are threatening with a minute left.
And Paul, you got to understand, these are just high school kids, man. But that makes it even more frustrating when that's not what you told them to defend or what play to call, and they just come back. And, you know, it's got to be frustrating on the coach's side of the field. But, hey, they're high school kids, man. They're just trying their best, man.
Absolutely. And clearly, both teams, you know, are well coached and well disciplined. And like I said before the game started, you're going to see a good game tonight, Jonathan.
It's old-fashioned Edinburg PSJA game.
Old-fashioned smash mouth, grind it out, low scoring, good game, no doubt. Bears in the huddle, they may do that real quick. When they break the huddle quickly, Florida's in the shotgun. Their stud, tailback, but he headed out the gut to the fullback and he
watches it down. Bears! 59 seconds left in the half, ladies and gentlemen. It's the PSJA Bears getting into the end zone with only 59 seconds left after a pass that was fumbled after a pickup of maybe, I don't know, 21 yards or something. It fumbled, took bounce, straight forward. Another receiver kept on running, perfect hop right into his hands. He took it down all the way down the 1 yard line. First play, PSJA Bears puts it in.
And that was a real good run by Christopher Sanchez, where the quarterback, it looked like he was going to give it to De La Salle on the outside, but headed up the gut. And a mishandled the snap to the holder. Holder, he hits him in the hands, and he drops the ball. So just like that, a miscue on the extra point. And that's a break.
Yeah, that might be big.
Wow.
Might be big. What's going on? All right, Pablo, here we go. I got a question for you, Pablo.
Yeah,
59 seconds.
Yes, sir.
Do you try and do something, or do you just go and regroup at halftime, or does it depend on where you start playing from, 20 to 10 or the 35 or the 40?
I was going to wait for your question, and my answer is let's see what kind of return they get. That will dictate. Let's say they don't get a
good
return.
What'd you call me?
A dictator?
Okay.
Let's say that they don't get a good return. They have poor field position.
They have no timeouts. So.
You can expect the econ, just run out the clock. Let's say they get a great return or a good return. Then you can expect
two timeouts.
Yeah, you can expect each
right
to give it a shot. But that's my opinion, Donnie. If they're pinned back, expecting them around the clock.
And Paul, thanks again. You know, we talk about this, and people talk about it. And they see me, and they say, "Hey, y'all make us want to be there." And it's
love it.
It's thanks to, you know, your side of the coaching side of, you know, making these people realize why you do this, why you expect this to happen, why as a coach you would do that. So again, Paul, thanks a lot for, you know, the information you give us.
Thanks, appreciate that, Donut.
Hey, they bring up,
I'm in my 20th year coaching.
They did bring up. You getting on me about me throwing flags up here, though.
Oh, well, yeah.
It's something,
you know, you got a yellow flag there, Donut. What is that? Former referee up here.
It's a cheeseburger wrapper.
And the ball is going to be a short squib kick, which is going to help out Econ, and then go through his hands, but be picked up on the 30, and looks like he's still on his feet. And we have a no answer as far as good or bad field position. It's on the 33, but you would expect Econ, you know, they would want to drive. They do have two timeouts, don't it?
Yeah.
But their forte is running the ball, and that's not good when you have 51 seconds left.
Now, PSJA will have a center fielder.
Well, that's a tough one, because if you have your secondary back, especially four DBs. You have seven in the box that's vulnerable to the run. But you want to give them the run because they grind out the clock. So I would expect the Bears.
There you go.
There you go. They have nine guys in the box. And it's a dive right in the middle. And he's on the 50. He's on the 40. He's on the 30.
No.
No. They no. Go.
The flag. You got a flag.
Touchdown. No, he called him out of bounds.
Down at the one. That flag. No, Pablo. No.
We are very upset here.
No, they were both tangled up, Pablo. They weren't even blocking each other, and he called it.
But the offense is out of jersey.
No, they were just swinging at each other.
All right, what we're talking about, ladies and gentlemen, was an absolutely gorgeous
run. Can we get a replay, please?
Gorgeous run down the right side.
Check it. We find it. See it on the replay, Pablo. We can get one, man. Come on.
We're very disappointed, certainly as fans, as professionals. What happened was the run, it was gone. It was 50 yards away, and you see a econ and a
the defender there made it obvious to, hey, look, call this, and he threw it.
And they're tangled up. The play was gone, ladies and gentlemen. At that point, all you got to do is just get away.
He's trying. The kid is trying to get away.
But, you know, hey, he should just raise up his hands.
He tried, Paul.
But then he engaged him. Then he said, no, I'm upset. But I'll tell you what, to the refs, you know, I know what you're saying, don't it? As a referee, you should call it on the defender because at some point in time, you have to defend yourself.
Yeah.
The other guy, at some point in time.
Exactly.
Yeah, and I know what you're saying. But you know what? They called it on Econ, and then they brought back what would have been a gorgeous 50-yard run. And just like that, it's a sweep to the left. And he got it on the outside.
Another holding. That one was a holding.
Carly Vela to the left side, a good run of 10, but it's going to be brought back. It's going to be holding.
That's fine. That was a good call there.
Yeah, you're right about that. I know we're both upset about that other call. As the ref let it go on forever. They just let him go. They let him go. Eventually, the econ, his guy, got upset. And then they called it on him, which makes no sense. But that's what they call. You have to live with the call.
So it's going to be a first and inches. It's not going to be a first and 11 coming up.
First now, it's on it. First and
11?
Yeah, first and 11.
All right, so it's going to be first and 11, 31 seconds left in the half, and the ball is going back all the way to their own 32.
Econ, just like that, they chipped away at the clock, but went nowhere. In their traditional formation, strong left if you're the Bears formation, it's going to be play action pass. He's got a man over in the middle, but it's intercepted by the Bears. That's too easy, as he was very well covered. Give credit to let me see here. Julian Garza, I mean, that was just too easy. He just had to step up.
Play center field,
He just played center field, and he just came up to catch a fly ball. That was easy. And just like that, with 24 seconds, the Bears have the ball. That was an ill-advised pass.
All right, they're going to be setting up right at the 43-yard line. That is of the Jaguars. Pablo, you have no timeouts. You have 24 seconds. You better find a way to stop the clock, because if you stay inbounds and you don't go out of bounds or it's completed pass or run, I don't think they're going to have time to set up again. Well, wait and see, ladies and gentlemen. We still got 24 seconds left in the half here at Edinburg Cat Stadium. It's the PSJA Bears 13, Jaguars from Economedes 7.
Motors in the shotgun. It's going to be he's going to roll out to his right. He may throw. He may keep it. He throws it. I don't know if they're going to give him credit for the catch.
Incomplete,
as you saw the quarterback move the pocket to the right with the option of either to run or to throw. And he did have a man open on the sideline, but he underthrew him. And you're right. I'm sure they're keenly aware, don't it, that they do not have timeouts. 19 seconds left.
All right. 19 seconds left. Ball just called it. It's going to be second and 10 coming up. They're at the 43-yard line. Pablo, what are you looking? They got to get at least to the 25 or somewhere in that area, the 20 to try.
Well, you know, they did. That was a great call. The quarterback rolls out, moves the pocket, so you give him the option to run. And so not only run, but run toward the sidelines. And if you have a man open, you throw it. It was there, just the bad pass.
All right, here we go.
Double twins, same play, but this time the Jaguar defense, unbelievable defensive stance. Let me see, I got a number here, 30-something. I'll tell you, I wish I had a number.
Flag.
Amador Puente making it just a beyond outstanding defensive play and disabled the quarterback, and it was a loss for PSJA.
Yeah, and left. It's a dead ball foul. It's going to go 15 yards against PSJA. So it'll take them back 15 yards, but they'll start the clock right afterwards, Paulo, and I don't think PSJA is going to try and run. Well, they are. They're talking to the quarterback. Maybe they're going to try and run one more, but you're asking for trouble if you ask me. Eight seconds left. They're going to start the clock. They're still not on the field. The quarterback is still over there with the coaches, so it's going to be hard for them to get something going within 8 seconds. Here we go. Here comes the ref. They set the ball. The sticks are set. And he's going to run the clock right now. Yes, sir. He's going to run the clock.
Yeah, that's it.
Seven.
Right half,
six. Five.
Oh, don't tell me he caught.
Oh, no. All right, so that's going to take us to halftime here, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, we're at Edinburg Cat Stadium where you were listening to Team Donut and Paul. With the halftime coming up, it's going to be the PSJ Bears 13, the Jaguars 7. Enjoy the halftime show.
Here is where we set out on a journey, giving top quality health care to our community. So we have affiliated with